Can there be a connection between Pumpkinhead and Jason Voorhees? After watching the first two films in the Pumpkinhead series, I had an intriguing thought after noticing both Pumpkinhead and Friday the 13th opens in 1957. What if Jason Voorhees was actually the result of a human giving birth to a child of the vengeance demon, Pumpkinhead? Similar to Tommy and Pumpkinhead too, granting Jason his supernatural powers and twisting his appearance as he grew older to resemble more of his demonic lineage. While I know it sounds far-fetched, the more I thought about it, the more it kinda made sense to me and became far easier to connect the lores. Although, this video is to only serve as a what-if scenario, only because I feel the Roy being the father of Jason and the death curse theories stand a lot better on their own and serve as parts of the canon, and not be diminished by something outside of the Friday the 13th lore itself. First, I want to start with the basis for this particular theory. Both characters share more than a few similarities when comparing Jason to Tommy. Both were born with extreme deformities and died agonizing deaths, with Jason either drowning due to negligence, which I fully believed he survived, or being hacked to death by a young Tommy Jarvis while protecting his sister Trish, and then Tommy being beaten, cut, and stabbed multiple times, then dropped down a shaft, only for both to return and wreak havoc as supernatural entities of vengeance. Now, the obvious difference between the two is their appearance. With Jason still looking very human outside of his deformities, and Tommy transforming into a spitting image of Pumpkinhead himself. Although if you watch carefully, the facial look and head shape of Jason in part 4 very much resembles almost that of Pumpkinhead. Although that could be a special effects optical illusion and me placing things that aren't really there into existence. I mean, considering what Jason looked like previously in parts 2, 3, and so forth. My theory is that Pamela could have been raped by either Pumpkinhead himself or one of his conjurers, based on the information and descriptions given by Pamela in the Pamela tapes from the game. Pamela would later give birth to Jason and marrying Elias, taking the Voorhees name for both Jason and herself, and always fearing that Jason's true father would come back for him, only to fall into madness after murdering Elias for hurting Jason and going on a murderous rampage after Jason drowned. Catching the attention of the witch, she offers Pamela a chance at revenge and casts a spell similar to the one that brought Tommy back in Pumpkinhead 2, but may have died before it could be completed, leaving the spell dormant until Pamela's death, only likely needing Pamela's blood to bring Jason back from the dead, just like Tommy was, which was flown from her neck wound into the lake after her decapitation. But with the spell not being complete, it only ages him from a boy to what we see in part 4, but doesn't fully transform into his demonic form that Tommy and Pumpkinhead share, making Jason a hybrid of human and demon, becoming more demonic with every murder, but always retaining his love for his mother. And because he's a hybrid, he has no human tether that can cause him pain, similar to Tommy, who felt his tether's pain, but didn't die after she did. In which Pumpkinhead differs here, because Pumpkinhead, if his tether dies, so does he. But Jason, being the result of botched magic, likely also resulted in causing hallucinations whenever Jason is within a certain radius, or likely just being in the campground itself where the spell was cast in the first place. And Jason never truly being able to die, trapping his spirit on Earth if physically killed, only for it to eventually return and begin again on his and Pamela's quest for vengeance. Which, if we use the New Line films as being canon to the Paramount ones, then once Jason is brought to hell, that would be a good way to tie in Savini Jason, and would be a great way to indicate to how Jason not only defeated the devil, but also took his pitchfork as well, showing that Jason's power has grown even past that of Pumpkinhead himself. But that's my theory. Do you agree? Could Jason and Pumpkinhead be related in some kind of way? Or do you believe that the Deadeye theory is far more plausible? Or are you like me and prefer Jason's origin stay linked to his own individual story with no ties to any other film? Although I gotta admit, after watching Pumpkinhead, it definitely made me think. Comment below with your own theories, and be sure to like, share, and subscribe, as well as hitting the notification bell to be alerted whenever a new video is uploaded or I go live for any of my now live streams, in which I'll be playing Dead by Daylight and possibly some other games. And you can talk to me live about any of my past videos or possibly future ones as well. And as always, I am JG Darhk, and thanks for watching.